Thank God for life. Welcome your neighbor this morning. Welcome your neighbor. Welcome your neighbor. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. Welcome your neighbor to today's service. Oh, Fasandari Kasundorobo Shikama Sendiria. Let's thank God for life this morning. Let's thank God for being here this morning. Appreciate Almighty God. Ramasundorobo Shikama Sendiria. Hora Baba Baba. Thank God you're alive and well. Oh, appreciate him. Rimo Sekeria. We don't take anything for granted. Rimo Sekeriga Sondorobo Shenderia. Hora Baba Bakasiria. Hori mo senderi kasiri ba kuntaria raba sondo bo senderia hora ba 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 ba. You are alive and well. Mariga somo bo senderia. You came here this morning without any problems. You take your bus. You took your car. You drove. No accident. Hora ba senderia raba somo bo senderia. You went into the bathroom. You had your bath yourself. You were not carried. Rama sondo bo senderia. You are not in the hospital. You are here this morning. Rama Sekeriga Sondorobo. Hora Baba. Rimo Sekeria. Rejoice in the Lord. Thank God for his mercies. Thank God for his blessings. Raga Sekeriga Sondorobo. Raga Gaga. Horobo Senderiga Sekeria. Rabba Senderiga Sondorobo Senderia. Hora Baba Bakasiria. Horobo Senderiga Sondorobo Senderia. What are you expecting from God this morning? Speak to the Almighty Father. He told us, he said, if it is impossible humanly, it is not impossible with him. Is there anything impossible for God? Rama Sonobo Shenderia. Open your mouth this morning. Speak to our Father. Rama Sekeriga Zenderia. That mountain, we are pulling it down in the mighty name of Jesus. That thing that looks impossible, God says there's nothing impossible. Rababa Sekeria. If you believe, if you have the faith and you believe in God, I said nothing is impossible. Rama Sekeria. Holy Baba Baba. He will even disappoint the doctors. Rimo Sekeriga Zekeria. There is nothing. Rima Sekeria. There is nothing. Riga Zekeriga Sondorobo. Oh Rababa. Rimo Sekeria. Rababa. Romo Sekeriga Zekeria. Hori mo senderia, rimo sekeriga zenderia, hori baba baba, horo bo senderia. God loves you so much. God, he loves you so much that he's ready to bless you. Rimo sekeria, rimbro no sekeriga zekeria. His word tells us in Deuteronomy 15:6. He said, I will bless you as I have promised. I will bless you as I've promised. You will not borrow, but you will lend to nation. He said, no nation shall rule over you, but you will rule over many nations. That is his promise, and it is yea and amen. What do you believe? Rama Sekeria, Rima Sekeriga Sondorobo, Riba Baba, Rimo Sekeria, Hora Baba, Horimo Sekeriga Sekeria, Horimo Senderia, Raga Gaga, Rimo Sekeria. Pray, pray, Masekeriga Sondorobo Senderia, Riba Baba Baba. Glory be to your name, glory be to your name, Rama Sondorobo Shikaba. In Jesus' name we have prayed. I want us to pray for the set man, Pastor Daniel Taiwo Dukoya. I want you to start speaking. Speak the word of God. Speak, speak, speak. In the name of your, pray for him. Pray for his family. Pray for his children. Pray for his grandchildren. Rama Sekeria. Pray for the church. Rimbrono Sekeria. Because I know he loves his church. He loves his church. He loves every member. He's always saying, I love you. Mariga Senderia. Pray for him. Pray for him. God will move him higher to higher levels in the mighty name of Jesus. Rabba Sekeriga Sondorobo. Rimo Sekeria. Rabba Baba. Spirit of wisdom. Spirit of counsel. Spirit of might, empower him in the mighty name of Jesus. Flood his heart with light in the mighty name of Jesus. Raga Sekeriga Sondorobo. Hora Baba. Rimo Sekeria. Hori Masiriba Kuntaria. Rimbrono Sekeria. Rabba Baba. God will keep him. God will protect him in the name of Jesus. He will see no evil in the name of Jesus. No evil fashioned against him shall prosper. Raga Sekeriga Sondorobo. Hora Baba. Hora Bosenderia. Rimo Sekeriga Sekeria. Hora Baba. Hora Basenderia. The words in his mouth is fire. In the name of Jesus, Rimo Shekere, Ora Baba, his words will not be sour. In the name of Jesus, Rimo Shekere, Gazekere, Ora Baba, Rimo Siriba Kuntaria, Ora Baba, Oro Mosendere, Gazekere, Ora Basekere, Gasondrobo, Rimo Shekere, Gazekere, Ora Baba, Orimo Shekere, Gasondrobo, Rimo Shekere, Gazekere, Ora Baba Kasiria, Oro Bosendere, Gasendere. In Jesus' name we have prayed. I want us to pray for our country, Nigeria. I want us to speak peace. We are expecting a new Nigeria. And we believe that it is coming. It is coming. I believe it is coming. And in that new Nigeria, the Bible says Nigeria shall be for righteousness. And we believe it. When it comes, people will be looking for Nigerians to attach themselves to us. In the name of Jesus, speak to Nigeria. What do you want from Nigeria? What do you want to see in our leaders? Ramasekeriga Somoboshine. No more corruption. In the name of Jesus, Ramasekeria. No more fraud. In the name of Jesus, Rama Sekeriga Sonorbo, Riba Baba, Oromo Senera, our leaders be leaders of integrity. In the name of Jesus, Rama Sondorobo Senera, Ora Baba, we come against every negativity in Nigeria. In the name of Jesus, Rama Sondorobo, Rimo Sekeria, Nigeria is for Jesus. Nigeria is for Jesus. Rima Sekeria. This country will not be Islamized. In the name of Jesus. Rima Sekeria. Rabababa. Rimo Siriba Kuntaria. O Rababa Kasekeria. O Rima Siriba Kuntaria. Rimo Sekeria. Rabababa. O Romo Sekeria. Rimo Sekeria. We speak life. No more kidnappings. No more deaths. In the name of Jesus. No more bad policies that does not favor the citizens. In the name of Jesus. Rabababa. O Robo Sekeria. We pull down every plan of the enemy. Any plan that does not align with the plan of God for Nigeria, we pull it down in the name of Jesus. Rama Sekeria, Rabba Baba, Horobo Sekeria, Horaba Baba Kasiria, Rimo Sekeria. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Rabba Kasiri Bakunta Masekeria. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Now, thank God for prayers answered. We believed we have raised our voices to the Lord. And we know he has heard us. So I want us to start thanking God for that which you are expecting for yourself, for that which you are expecting for Nigeria, for that which you are expecting for Fountain of Life Church, Masekeria, for our Pastor Taiwo Dukoya. Start thanking God, for we are going to see the miracle hands of God in our lives in the name of Jesus. Rabba Sekeria, what shall separate us from the love of God? Rimo Sekeria, nothing shall separate us from the love of God. In the name of Jesus, Raga Sekeria, Rima Sekeriga Sondobo, we pull down every negativity. In the name of Jesus, Rama Sondobo, Rima Sekeria, Rabba Baba, Horobo Senderia, Riga Sekeriga Sondobo, Rimo Sekeriga Senderia. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you, Lord. We bless your holy name, for you are a good God. You are everything to us, Almighty God. Thank you, Lord, for the Holy Spirit. We pray the blood of Jesus over everyone here this morning. In the name of Jesus, we pray the blood of Jesus over every activity this morning. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Almighty God. In Jesus' wonderful name, we have prayed. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He's worthy.
Oh, that man will praise the Lord. Oh, that man will praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men, to the children of men, for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men, to the children of men. He has broken the gates of bars and cut the bars of iron asunder. He has broken the gates of bars and cut the bars of iron asunder.
Oh, that man will praise the Lord.
Oh, that man,
oh, that man will praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
For his goodness and for his wonderful works.
Children of men.
Wonderful one, to the children of men, to the children of me, has broken the
With his feathers, and under his wings shall we take refuge. His truth shall be our shield and our buckler. We shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor the destruction that lays waste at noonday. 1,000 may fall at our side, 10,000 at our right hand, but it shall not come near us. Only with our eyes shall we look and see the reward of the wicked. Because we have made the Lord our refuge, even the Most High our dwelling place, no evil. Because we dwell in the secret place of the Most High, we shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. We will say of the Lord, He is our refuge and our fortress. Our God, in Him shall we trust. Surely He will deliver us from the snare of the fowler and from every perilous pestilence. He will cover us with His feathers, and under His wings shall we take refuge. His truth shall be our shield and our buckler. We shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor the destruction that lays waste at noonday. 1,000 may fall at our side, 10,000 at our right hand, but it shall not come near us. Only with our eyes shall we look and see the reward of the wicked. Because we have made the Lord our refuge, even the Most High our dwelling place, no evil shall befall us, nor shall any plague come near our dwelling place. For He will give His angels charge over us, to keep us in all our ways. In their hands they shall bear us up, lest we dash our foot against a stone. We shall tread upon the lion and the cobra, upon the young lion and the serpent shall we trample under our feet. Because we have set our love upon Him, therefore He will deliver us. He will set us up on high, because we have known His name. We will call upon Him and He will answer us. He will be with us in trouble. He will deliver us and honor us. With long life will He satisfy us and show us His salvation.
Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! We serve a God who has loved us with an everlasting love. And this morning we have only come to affirm and to accept and to declare that we love the Lord. And because we love the Lord, He will keep us from all evil. Because He loved us first. Today, as we minister, please embark in the love of Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, I love You. How I love You. More and more, each day. I just want to be close to You. Under the shadow of Your wings, please hide me, Lord, so that I might be close to You. Presence is fullness of joy, of joy. I rest Your right hand, a pleasure forever, evermore. Can stand.
close to you. Ooh, 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 ooh. Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
How I love you.
How I love you.
More and more.
More and more. Each day. I just want to be close.
To be close. Oh,
safe in the arms of Jesus. We're going to be praying this morning, and we're going to pray for our nation, pray for the Fountain of Life Church, and pray for ourselves. And we're just going to be pleading the blood of Jesus. And I want to encourage us, don't get distracted as we plead the blood of Jesus. The most powerful tool this side of heaven, the blood of Jesus, in whom all the power of the covenant resides. When we say we plead the blood of Jesus, we're declaring the life of God. The Bible says the life of every creature is in the blood. When we plead the blood of Jesus, we're declaring life. When we plead the blood of Jesus, we're enforcing all that was wrought at Calvary. When we plead the blood of Jesus, we're saying we stand by the covenant. And every blessing and deliverable of the covenant, we're enforcing it. So please, we're going to plead the blood of Jesus. We're going to pray in the Spirit. But keep your focus. The Bible says we overcome by the blood of the Lamb. We overcome everything contrary, every lie of hell, every threat of darkness. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. We testify that the blood, we believe in the blood. So this morning, could we just rise to our feet as we begin to plead the blood of Jesus over our nation, Nigeria? Just plead the blood of Jesus over our nation, Nigeria. The blood will answer every question we have. The blood will settle every uncertainty. The blood will avail in every area of this nation. Is it our economy? Is it our security? Is it our education? Is it our health? Is it the moral fabric of this nation? Just plead the blood of Jesus. Just declare, I plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. It's not an empty statement. Hell knows it's not an empty statement. The blood of Jesus. Heaven rejoices when we plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. Over our nation, Nigeria, we plead the blood of Jesus. North, south, east, west, the center, we plead the blood of Jesus. Concerning our politics, we plead the blood of Jesus. Concerning the coming elections, we plead the blood of Jesus. Concerning peace in our land, we plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. Over our nation, Nigeria, we plead the blood of Jesus. Concerning our security, we plead the blood of Jesus. Concerning our economy, we plead the blood of Jesus. 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 Hey, abaria kasoro boriakasi. Hey, abakasi rabi rabi rabi. Hey, abaria baruru rei 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 rei. Ayabi yabi 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 yabi. Iribi rabi abababa. Orobi abi 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 abi. Hey, abari ari ari. Eri ari ari ari. Eri ari ari ari. Eri ari ari. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus over our nation. We plead the blood of Jesus over our nation. We plead the blood of Jesus over our nation. For our today, for our tomorrow, for our future. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus against every plan of hell against this nation. We plead the blood of Jesus against every plot of darkness against this nation. We plead the blood of Jesus against the gang up of men and whatever evil strategies they have. We plead the blood of Jesus. We declare in Jesus' name, the blood has a final say. The blood has a final say. We plead the blood of Jesus. 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 We plead the blood of Jesus over our nation, Nigeria. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. The blood avails for this nation. The blood avails for this nation. Because we're here, the blood of Jesus avails for this nation. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus against every plot of hell, against every plot of darkness. We plead the blood of Jesus. 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 We raise the everlasting standard of our covenant over this nation. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood that will never lose its power. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. The blood shall speak for this land. The blood shall avail for this land. The blood shall fight for this land. The blood will contend against all that contend with this nation. We plead the blood of Jesus. 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 In Jesus' name. We're now going to be praying for the Fountain of Life Church, also declaring the blood of Jesus. The word of the Lord for this church is that the Lord will build this church and the gates of hell will never prevail. Concerning the mandate given to this house, given to our senior pastor, given to the mandate, the purpose, that which was in the heart of God when he created the Fountain of Life Church. We're going to plead the blood of Jesus over it. We're going to plead the blood of Jesus over our senior pastor, Pastor Taiwo Daniel Odukoya, and his entire family. We plead the blood of the blood shall continually speak. The blood shall silence every contrary voice. The blood shall destroy every contrary counsel. Begin to plead the blood of Jesus over the Fountain of Life Church. We plead the blood of Jesus over the Fountain of Life Church. We plead the blood of Jesus, silencing every other voice that is speaking against the voice of our God concerning our church. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus over the Fountain of Life Church. We say the blood of Jesus has the final say. We say the blood of Jesus is the final consideration. We say the blood of Jesus is the last word concerning this house. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus over Pastor Taiwo Daniel Odukoya. We plead the blood of Jesus over all his children, their spouses and their children, his grandchildren. We plead the blood of Jesus over all pastor's siblings, their spouses, their children and grandchildren. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus over Pastor Taiwo Odukoya, spirit, soul and body, everything concerning him. We plead the blood of Jesus. We say the blood fights. We say the blood contends with everything contrary. We say the blood destroys everything that is not of the Lord. We say every other voice, every contrary voice is silenced by the blood. For the blood speaks concerning Pastor Taiwo. The blood speaks concerning his family. The blood speaks concerning the Fountain of Life Church. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus over the mandate given to this house, over God's purpose and desire and plan for this house. We plead the blood of Jesus. 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 Hey, abakaria kasoro boria. Hey, abaria baria 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 ba. We plead the blood of Jesus. We raise the everlasting standard of our covenant. The blood of Jesus over this house. The blood has the final say. The blood is the final consideration. We plead the blood of Jesus. The blood that can never lose its power. The love blood that can never lose its power. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus over the Fountain of Life Church. Over every member of this church. Over every man. And every woman, every boy, every girl, every family in the Fountain of Life Church all over the world, we plead the blood of Jesus. We say the blood avails. 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 We say the blood is a final word. The blood is a final consideration. We plead the blood of Jesus against every lie of hell, against every onslaught of darkness, against every work of darkness. We say the blood of Jesus stands against you. We plead the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Now we're going to plead the blood over your life, over your family, everyone the Lord has given you to love. Every area of your life, continually cover in the blood of Jesus. You know what the devil is threatening you with, or lying to you about, or contending with you? Begin to plead the blood of Jesus. Just plead the blood of Jesus. Just plead the blood of Jesus over your spouse, over your children, over your parents, over your siblings, over everything the Lord has blessed you with, your home, your property, your health, your life, your thoughts, everything, whatever lie the enemy is. Are you ill in your body? Plead the blood of Jesus against that sickness and disease. Are you fighting with doubt and fear? Plead the blood of Jesus against every lying, deceiving spirit. Just plead the blood of Jesus. Cover your life with the blood of Jesus. Plead the blood of Jesus. I 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 plead the blood of Jesus. Plead the blood of Jesus over your spirit. Plead the blood of Jesus over your soul. Plead the blood of Jesus over your body. Plead the blood of Jesus over your family. Plead the blood of Jesus over the works of your hands. Plead the blood of Jesus over your health. Plead the blood of Jesus over your finances. Plead the blood of Jesus over your plans. Plead the blood of Jesus over every day of the rest of this month and for the rest of this year, going into 2023. We plead the blood of Jesus. We seal our lives with the blood of Jesus. We seal our lives with the blood of Jesus. We seal our lives with the blood of Jesus. We seal our lives with the blood of Jesus. We come against every lie of darkness by the power and the blood of Jesus. We come against every threat of hell with the power and the blood of Jesus. We silence every contrary voice speaking with the blood of Jesus. We cancel every contrary counsel by the blood of Jesus. We plead 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 the blood of Jesus over our thoughts, over our words, over our deeds. The blood of Jesus, spirit, soul, and body. The blood of Jesus over everything that concerns us. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. Our today, our tomorrow, our future. We plead the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you for the power in the blood of Jesus. We thank you that your blood can never lose its power. Every day the power is fresh. Father, we cover the entirety of our lives with the blood of Jesus. We raise the everlasting standard of your covenant, the blood, over our lives. Over our today, our tomorrow, our future, we plead the blood of Jesus. Over all you've blessed us with, our spouses, our children, our siblings and their families, our businesses, our careers, our health, everything with our name on it, we soak in the blood of Jesus. We declare the blood has the final say. We declare concerning our lives, your blood will continually speak mercy. Will continually speak grace. Will continually speak provision. Will continually speak protection. Will continually speak abundance. Will continually speak victory. Will continually speak triumph. Will continually speak peace. Every benefit of the covenant, we appropriate afresh this morning. As we've covered this nation, covered this house, covered our senior pastor and his family, and covered our own lives with the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, thank you, thank you. In Jesus' name we've prayed.
Here's a disclaimer. Gilgal Partners is acting as solicitors to Pastor Taiwo Dukoya, the senior pastor of the Fountain of Life Church, headquartered in Nigeria. On Tuesday, November 8th, 2022, it was brought to our attention that some individuals created a cryptocurrency trading WhatsApp group using as an administrator a phone number known as +234 904 534 0404, purported to be our client's number, using one of his photographs which existed in the public domain, and reaching out to individuals and organizations within his network for participation and patronage. We have since reported these fraudulent activities to the Nigerian Police Force for thorough investigation. Permit us to inform the public that our client has never created any WhatsApp group for the purpose of trading cryptocurrency, neither has he ever used the number with which the said WhatsApp group was created for personal or official purposes, and the same is not registered to his name with any mobile service provider in Nigeria. And he does not trade in cryptocurrency, nor render any financial service or services online and offline, either directly or by proxy, and has never held out any person or organization as his agent in this regard. We therefore appeal to his network and members of the public to completely disregard any misrepresentation and impersonation of this nature and related ones, and do not hesitate to bring to our notice any of such unscrupulous activities which comes to your attention. Thank you. Signed, Taiwo Akinlami, Esquire, Principal Partner. This morning on Fountain News, Heritage of Grace presents stage play this afternoon, and Outreach Department holds Love Feast for Converts next Sunday. Good morning and welcome to this episode of Fountain News. I am Ibora Tonya Edit. Now here are highlights of events that happened in the past week. Now the Fountain of Life Church, through one of its outreaches, the Education Support Project, ESP, has honored 12 teachers, 14 students and 7 retired principals of the secondary schools in Ilupeju for their hard work, dedication and excellence. The awardees were from Ilupeju Junior and Senior Secondary Schools, Estate Junior and Senior Secondary Schools and Ilupeju Junior and Senior Grammar Schools. Recognition awards were given to the retired principals, merit awards were given to the teachers and scholarship awards were given to the students by the church. Our senior pastor was represented at the event by Pastor Tayo Kujore. Others in attendance were the head and members of the ESP, awardees, as well as their families and well-wishers.
There will be a special love feast for those who gave their lives to Christ between August and November 2022, next Sunday, after the second service. Venue is the Multipurpose Hall. Now, the Heritage of Grace, that is the drama department of this church, presents a stage play titled Mbeleko today at 3 p.m. Venue is the church auditorium. It promises to be an exciting and inspiring place, so don't come alone. Make sure you bring your friends and family along. Now, are you getting ready for the 2022 Annual Business Fellowship Trade Fair? It promises to be exciting and rewarding to all, especially the exhibitors. Now, if you are a business person and would like to exhibit your products or services at the fair, please make your booking without any delay. Premium stalls go for 30,000 Naira, standard stalls for 20,000 Naira, and food courts go for 35,000 Naira. Payments should be made to the Fountain of Life Church Zenith account number 10101319 44. Please write Trade Fair as the description and send a screenshot of your payment slip via WhatsApp to 0803-314-7146. For inquiry, please visit the Business Fellowship stand outside after the service, or you can call Funke Shewole on 0803-314-7146 or Idayat Briggs on 0908-005-3551. Due to the annual business trade fair holding on December 4, 2022, the Hope Center has rescheduled her monthly collection date for this Sunday, November 27, and Sunday, December 11, 2022. Members of the department will be available at the Fountain Gardens to receive all items on these dates. You can also visit the Hope Center stand at the annual trade fair to purchase household appliances, clothes, shoes, and more at discounted prices. Please note that proceeds from these sales items will be used to support the less privileged. Have you completed the Believer's Class but are yet to be water baptized by immersion? If your answer is yes, then this is for you. There will be water baptism this Saturday at 10 a.m. and venue is the church premises. Please come along with a change of clothes. Now, in other announcements, Children's Church holds both on-site and online today. Please note that the online classes start at 7:30 a.m. and 10:30 a.m. respectively. Home fellowship holds this evening at 6 o'clock. Singles fellowship comes up tomorrow at 6 p.m. and Bible study continues online on Tuesday at 6 p.m. while prayer meeting follows at 6:45 p.m. Remember, the shower service holds on-site and online this Thursday at 9 a.m. Now, when last did you have your blood pressure checked? Don't forget to drop by the Multipurpose Hall after this service for your blood pressure check. Now, if your birthday or wedding anniversary was last week or is today, please rise as we rejoice with you.
Happy birthday, happy wedding anniversary. We celebrate with you. We celebrate you, Pastor Tinu. Happy anniversary. We celebrate with you. We pray that God will continue to bless you. He will continue to keep you. He will cause his face to shine upon you. And the Egyptians that you have seen before now, you will see them no more forever in the name of Jesus. For wedding anniversary, it will get sweeter and better with age in the name of Jesus. Your homes are blessed in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. In Jesus' name we've prayed. Amen. Congratulations. You may be seated. Now, if you're worshiping with us for the very first time in the Fountain of Life Church, please can you rise up on your feet for recognition? Hallelujah. Welcome to the Fountain of Life Church. Personally, I say this is where God resides. He's here 24/7, 7 days a week. He neither sleeps, he does not slumber. This is where God is, and we are glad that you have come to fellowship with us today. We encourage you to become part of us and join the beautiful work that God is doing here. We would definitely love to see you again. Please fill the forms that the ushers have given to you. Please fill them in capital letters so that we can get in touch with you. God bless you as you do so. You may be seated. Good morning, church. I cannot hear you. Good morning, church. The psalmist says, I was glad when they said to us, let us go into the house of the Lord. And God has a beautiful promise for us this morning. It's in Matthew 19, verse 26. It says, but Jesus looked at them and said to them, with men, this is impossible. But with God, all things are possible. Just to get a bit of context, this was a man that came to meet Jesus, and Jesus was giving him an opportunity to follow him. And he said, leave all that you have and follow me. And Bible said he walked away feeling very downcasted. And Jesus said, it's hard, you know, for a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven. And the disciples then said, how can it then happen? Jesus said, with man, this is impossible. If you will, I'd like to read the Message translation, but I would read from verse 25. It says, then the disciples were staggered. Then who has any chance at all? Jesus looked hard at them and said, not a chance at all if you think you can pull it off yourself. Every chance in the world if you trust God. I don't know what your this is. You know, the this that we bring to church will be different. For someone, their this is a child. For someone, their this is a husband. For someone, their this is their prayer life, their spiritual life. For someone else, their this is a salvation. For another person, their this is a business contract. Their this, you know, whatever your this is, tell your neighbor you have come to the right place. Because this is the place where every this can be met. So regardless of what you have brought into the house this morning, we have an assurance that even if men have said it's impossible, I want you to tell yourself there is a God of possibility. So man may say impossible. My God says it's possible. I read a book by Oral Roberts 1. It says how to see the invincible and do the impossible. And it says the kind of things it takes to his God are things that men have written off. Things that men have said cannot happen. And it says it takes it to his God because he has an assurance that my God can do exceedingly, abundantly, above all I can ever ask, think, or imagine. I don't know if you have been bringing that this to church Sunday in and Sunday out, and nothing has happened. But I have good news for you today. This is your moment. This is that day that you are not going back the same way that you have come. This is that day that that dead womb will carry a child, regardless of what the doctor's report is. This is that day that that prayer life gets on and catch on fire for God. This is that day that that lost son or daughter is coming back home. This is that day that that husband is getting a revival. This is that day that that business is getting a turnaround. I want you to be upset with the status quo and say that I am not going back the same way I've come into the service today. The Bible says that as soon as Zion travailed, he brought forth. I want someone to bring forth this morning and say that this is the day. I have brought my this to the altar of God this morning, and I am not going back with it, because with my God, all things are possible. I am returning with my testimony. I brought a this to God, and he got a turnaround. In the name of Jesus, we thank you that every this that we have brought into the old church this morning is becoming a possibility. In the name of Jesus, we pay no regards to the doctor's report. We pay no regard to the economic report. We pay no regard to the medical or social report. But whose reports do we believe? We believe the report of our God. And our God says all things are possible. God said it. We believe it. That settles it. Father, we thank you, for it is settled. Your word indeed, I hear and amen. And we thank you that we will return with a testimony that every impossibility we have laid on your altar this morning has been made possible. We give you all the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Now we put a praise on it. Hallelujah.
Yeah, yeah.
go finish for my mouth. Hallelujah, no go finish for my mouth. Hallelujah, no go finish for my mouth. Oh. Hallelujah, no go finish from my mouth. Oh. Hallelujah, no go finish from my mouth. Oh. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Many years ago, this veteran gospel artist in Nigeria, Bola Are, sang a song. Oh, the hallelujah, lo wo di Jericho. Can someone help me? Hallelujah. It was hallelujah that brought down the walls of Jericho. I don't know what's constituting a wall. Before you today. It's coming down. In the name of Jesus, it's coming down. Somebody shout hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah! Walls crumbling, hallelujah! Come on, shout, hallelujah! We give God the glory. Father, take all the glory, take all the glory, take all the glory. We're shouting hallelujah. A song was breaking out in my spirit, man. You see what song, honey? Yeah, hallelujah, Jesus conquered the world. Now listen, Satan.
The Lord in my life today. Hallelujah, Jesus conquered the world. Hallelujah, Satan, you are in trouble. The Lord reigned in my life.
Now, we corrected it before I left school. So it changed from not hallelujah, Jesus conquered the world. Hallelujah, Satan. No. It's hallelujah, Jesus conquered the world. Now listen, Satan. Woo! The Lord reigned in my.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah, Jesus conquered the world. Now listen, Satan, you are in trouble. The Lord reigned in Nigeria today.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now listen, Satan, you are in trouble.
The Lord.
The Lord.
on, let me hear you sing. Bakatalabo, Rabata Shakata, Rabata Bakatobo.
Satan, you are in trouble.
The Lord reigns.
The Lord reigns in Nigeria too.
Hallelujah.
Bakatalabo.
Now listen.
Now listen. Satan, you are in trouble.
The Lord reigns.
To declare the Lord raised in Nigeria, Maka Shakata Baba. I said the Lord raised in Nigeria, Makotolobo Shikanda Baba, Laka Shakata Baba. Lift up your voices, make a declaration. Makanta Baka Shota Broko Shotia, Nakata Boko Shonda Baba, Makata Braka Shada Brakatolia, Nakanta Braka Shonda Braka Shada Brakasolia, Nakaribo Kosonda Brikashenda Brikitalia. Kashakata marola braba bakashadaba apa katoba kashadaba. The Lord reigns in Nigeria today. The Lord reigns in Nigeria today. In our body play politics Nigeria, the Lord reigns in Nigeria today. In our educational sector, the Lord reigns in Nigeria today. Makashakata baba makotora bakashakata baba lakanda broko shonda brakashakata baba rakata baba. Lift your voices and declare makatora boko shonda brakashadaba. Nakoto braka shanda baba, makata braka sunda braka shadi bokosolia, nakata broko sunda beke shadi beke tilia, shakata broko katolia, shakata braba baba, makata broko tona braka shanda braka tona baka shadia, nakata baka tona braka shanda braka tolia, nakashakata madam broko sunda beke shadia, nakata broko shokota baka shakata ba, roboko saka shakata braba baba, malipaka sanda braka shoda braba baba. The Lord reigns in the Fountain of Life Church today. Makashakata, Lakanta Broko Shonda Brakashikia, Lakanta Brakashonda Brakashada Brakatoria, Makata Broko Sonda Brakashenda Brakatalia, Kashakata Baba, Lakata Baba Baba, Lakatura Brakashada Brakatura Bakashika, Lakashakata Brakashada Brakatura Brakashadaba, Lakandora Bakatum Brakashiria, Rikeshikete Beke Shokuru Bakashaka, Lakata Bakashakata Baba. Makatoro boko shonde breveke shenda brababa. Lakata brava katoro brava shanda braka shanda braka shonde breveke sheria. Deke to brava breveke shenda brava shanda ba. Lakata boko toro breveke sheria. Nakasha kata brababa. Mara bakatoro brava shanda brava katoria. Makasha kata brababa. Maru koto barika shanda braka shanda bakatoro ba. Moko toro braka shanda ba. The Lord reigns in my life. He reigns in my family. He reigns in the lives of my children. Makasha today. Makasha kata bakasha kala. Nakotora bakashanda brakasura brakasheria. Nakada bakasura bakashanda bakataria. Nakata bokotonde brebekeshende brekeseria. Nakata brokosura brakashakata brababa. Makata brokosura bakashaka de bakatalaba. Makata bakashakata bada bakashaka. Nakatura brakashanda brakatura brakashaka. Nakatura bakashanda brakatura brakasheria. Nakata brakasura brakashata. Makata brabada bakasalabaka. Makatura brakashanda brakasheba. Nakata brakasura brakashanda bakasuria. Kashkanda makatu. Mariba Cassandra Brabacasura Baba, Macata Brabacataba, Lacata Brocosura Becassia Becatilla, Lacasha Catababa, Bacasota Bracashataba, Lacanda Brabacasuna Bracashadi Bocosuria, Manto Brocosuna Becassia, Macasatala. Begin to give him praise, begin to thank him. He's a faithful God, he lives up to his word. Macashakata Bracasuria, we give him honor, we give him praise, we thank you, Father. Take all the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. But there's one more prayer point. I have one more prayer point. You see, at the time, see God, amazing God. It was God and Abraham. Then God and Abraham. And there was a deal between God and, thank you, Jesus. One man and God. And when the man was finding it difficult to to fully understand, because he just couldn't see what God was saying, he showed him the stars, he showed him the sands on the sea. Can't, if you can, he couldn't. He said, let me tell you this. And when he was again, later, when he was again, I said, CST don't have a child. He said, Lord, listen to me. You're talking of a child, I'm talking of nations. He said, hear me. There will be many. In fact, as a matter of fact, there'll be slaves in the foreign land for over 400 years. But he was there to see one child. And God was saying that. So invariably, when they came and they had these troubles in Egypt, they didn't know what has happened behind, what has transpired behind. They just found themselves being born into slavery and they were like, what? And they were struggling. Some things were settled before you were even born. Not so much with the devil, but with God. You say, what about where our parents are? That's their business. I'm talking of God, your creator. They always made provisions for your escape everywhere and just your establishment. He's made it. The ignorance of your parents cannot bind you forever. He wrote it. I'm not joking, it's true. And so when it was time, I said, come out, and was using Moses, and everything looked stiff, like, does God really answer prayer? Somebody said to me, he said, I'm so tired. I prayed and prayed, look like God is not answering. I felt like turning to the other side. I said, which other side? When they began to feel like that, he said, you know what? One more thing. The blood. And before, he said, this time around, he won't just let them go. He will chase them out. Your troubles will chase you out of every home. I mean, your trouble will get overwhelmed. He will be praying that you quickly get out. In the name of Jesus, they've made a mistake that they got into this trouble with you. I don't know what I'm talking about. He said, this time around, it looked like a joke. After they've tried 9 times, say this time around, the blood. They were glad that the children of Israel left. Gosh, I feel the fire. Those defiant devils and altars are in trouble right now. In the name of Jesus, they are. So you're still going to plead the blood of Jesus. And you crown it with every obstinate and defiant altar and voice and demons. Back to sender. In the name of Jesus. Now you don't have to pray that prayer. That's what I'm praying. If we try, in the name of Jesus. You think you are stubborn? You will go back and harm yourself. The Bible says they pick the door for your soul, they will be buried in themselves. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, glory be to God in the highest. Oh yes, the trap is laid out for you. It will catch them, not you, in Jesus' name. They are incensed against you. They must bring down. They will not only fail, they'll be disgraced and ashamed. Their dishonor will be everlasting. I say in the name of Jesus. The one that will pursue will not give up. You always have the opportunity to be let that the sword pursue you become poor. God is so merciful. But if you begin to despise the mercy of God, you think, by Yakaraba, the Red Sea will settle the matter. In the name of Jesus. I said, the Red Sea. Why? The Red Sea that is set up for you, you will pass through. But they will not come out. The gallows set for you, you will come out celebrating. They will hang on their gallows. Open your mouth. Every defiant altar, every stubborn, every covenanted evil against you. Back to sender. Maka shata la barababa. Matoro prokoshenda braka shata braka sata braka soteria. Maka toda. The blood of Jesus works for you. Maka shaka la baba. Marula braka sanda katora braka shanda braka sura braka setia. Raka shkata barababa. Nakataba this November, this December. I say, anywhere your name is mentioned for evil. Sender in the name of Jesus. Anywhere fountain is mentioned for evil. Back to sender in the name of Jesus. Anywhere my family, my children, I mean your spouse, mentioned for evil. Back to sender in the name of Jesus. Oh yes, Marabaka Shada Baba. Lakatura Braka Shada Braka Tombra Kushudia. Raka Sote Brebe Bekeshende Breke Surya. Makata Baba Bakatura Baka Shada Bakasada. Nekoto bakashanda prabakasanda. Mara bakatora brekashanda brakatora brekashanda brekashanda. Makata brakosunda brekashanda brekashanda brekashanda. Nakashada brababara. Katora brakashanda brakasunda brekashanda. Rakashka bada bakatoria. I say back to sender. Back to sender. Back to sender. In the name of Jesus, I say back to sender. Makasura brakashanda brakasura brakashanda. Nakatora brakashanda brakatora brakashanda brakasura. Katopa kashata brakatora brababa. Makatora, I pray the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus against you, against you. In the name of Jesus, I forbid and I Makotora bashakata brababa. Rakotora bakashanda brabada bakasura baba. Come on, begin to give him praise. Begin to give him praise. Begin to give him honor. Makashura brabakashada. Matura brakashada bakatura brakashada brakatura ba. Nakatura brabakashanda brakasura brakashanda kata brakatura. Hallelujah. Jesus can conquer the world. Now listen, Satan, you are in trouble. The Lord reigned in my life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus conquered
the world.
Now listen.
Now listen. Satan, you are in trouble.
The Lord reigned.
The Lord
in my life.
In my life today.
Amen. Just before I hand over the mic for the worship session, just a few announcements. Hallelujah. Yes, there will be a film show today. You can be seated. Some people are older than other people. Yeah, those who cannot stand at all is either they are old or they are not feeling fine. And we recognize old age anyway. But if you are younger, you're behaving like an old person. I think you need prayers. Glory be to God in the highest. Yes. So today, 3 p.m., right in this auditorium, let's come and thank God for the lives of our members of Heritage of Grace, our drama department. They've really worked hard, and they're bringing, I think, a beautiful folk. Is it folk? What do you call it? Folklore. Thank you. From South Africa. Part of their culture. And what makes this unique is that when they were writing the scripts, they brought it to the consultant pastor, Namti, who really, she introduced quite a bit of things and made it clearer to them. And so you can bet you are going to have a good time. You think you're in South Africa. Last week I made a mistake of saying, it's not her life story. Far from it. But she was part of the script. Script written by our own sister Fentola Olulano. Wonderful lady. God bless her. Amen. Yes. Hallelujah. And so come 3 o'clock. And like you've heard, come and just come in a relaxed mood. In a relaxed mood, come with your families and friends and neighbors. We believe God that God will touch them too in Jesus' name. And then this coming Sunday, by the grace of God, is our Thanksgiving. In my language, Abiko Sherefu. Abiko Dai Olari. Pastor Tosin, you seem to be the best here. Hey, let them know what we just said. Quickly. Hey, no, they're bringing you the mic. So.
Hasn't he done you good?
Hasn't he done you good?
Hasn't he vindicated you?
Hasn't he?
His blood has done great things.
Oh, yeah.
So, of course, we thank God.
So, I believe everybody falls into that category. So, we hope to see you on Sunday. Come with families and friends. It's time to really give God all the glory he deserves. We've been doing that, but we want to demonstrate our gratitude, as it were, to him. So please come Sunday. Service is time at the same, but it's going to be fully thanksgiving by the grace of God. Hallelujah. If anybody really has to thank God, I think I have more reasons. And I'm so grateful to God. Hallelujah. And then the third thing, this Saturday, by God's grace. No, 2 weeks' time, right? Yeah. Sunday. No, I'm talking of, two Sundays to come. That's the 4th of December. Yes. is our trade fair, and the promises to be on you. Come on, give God the good of him. Yeah. And the promises to be the best that we've ever had by the grace of God. You say, why? Because of the times and the seasons. Everybody's complaining, everything is tight. But God, in his infinite mercy, is opening doors for us. And but to say it like it's really going to be, let me invite the head of the department, Dr. Yeli Okereme, to come and at least give you some hints of what to expect. Yes, Brother Yeli, God bless you. Yep. It was around in the first service, and I think it should be around. Oh, yeah, that's him coming. Yeah.
Morning, sir. Said it will be the best ever. I can give you a peep into 1, 2, 3 things that might happen there, but they are good things. So, as usual, we're going to have a raffle draw promising so many beauties for the season. Who knows? For 50 naira, something really nice might just become yours. But believe me, it's going to be in values of exponential values of 50 naira. The grace, the healing streams will be there, taking a look at every one of us, because we also know that health is wealth. But the bottom line is, for every businessman, every businesswoman that wants to be seen, that wants to be visible, it's an opportunity to be there to showcase what you're doing. The beauty of trade fairs is not just what you sell there, but what happens after, because you then project to the world what your capabilities might be. We look forward to seeing you. The stalls are selling out fast, but I trust that if we hurry, we might just be lucky to get your own stall. And so many people are going to come, because that's one of the things that we guarantee. People are going to exhibit, so many people. The entire Ilupeju environs have been sensitized on the social media, on traditional media. So much information is being spread, and it promises to be fulfilling. But that's just one part of what the business fellowship, through the vision of the father of the house, is doing. We understand the challenging times and seasons, and very many entrepreneurs, when we speak to them, they are challenged. Well, it's not unexpected, particularly coming out of a major pandemic, shutdowns and stuff like that. So many businesses are rebooting. Many businesses need to completely pivot and do something new. But one of the things we know as entrepreneurs is that 3 things challenge entrepreneurs. And one, those 3 things are information, connection, and resources. Number of times when we interview entrepreneurs and those of us who sit down in pitches, you identify that these are people, the only thing they need is just a little information and it changes their life altogether. Sometimes the problem is they need to meet Pastor Shimbajo, who's going to connect them to his network. And sometimes the challenge is that they need cash, because the Bible says money answers all things. Now, these 3 things are important and need to be mixed in an optimal manner for any business to really go forward. And these are the 3 things that the business fellowship is putting in place. By the grace of God, they're putting the fund together. It keeps growing by the day. And the whole idea is such that everybody in this house will become self-sufficient. And no one will ever be left behind. Because it's possible for us to come here and preach, God bless you, and feel good. And if we do not meet these physical needs, we still haven't occupied according to the instructions of God. And Pastor intends that we occupy until he comes. And so there's funds there, and we will be looking at all your kind of proposals. And we have a very strong team of people who are going to look at proposals. And some of the proposals, like I said, if it is money, by the grace of God, we will have money to put behind it. If it is connections, because sometimes it's just about people having the right connection to where they want to go. And sometimes, if it is information, the three of them are going to be available. We will be talking a lot more. We'll be sharing a lot more information about this in the coming weeks. But we intend that this fund is going to be sustainable. So it's not the kind of fund we're going to give people and people are going to take the money to have parties and buy cars and stuff like that. No. It's the kind of money that's a seed. I trust that Fountaineers, we don't eat our seed. We plant our seed and we expect harvests. It's the kind of money that we expect to put into your business so that your business grows and then you return the money and perhaps in future you partner and also sponsor other people. Finally, our doors remain open to our partners, some who want to give some more money to the fund. Because God has blessed you to that level, we look forward to such opportunities. God bless you. We've seen people who have the skill, who have the knowledge, and who have the contact, and they want to partner with us. We look forward to working with you. We'll be working very, very closely with the cooperative. Because the honest truth is that this church has done a whole lot of things that I think government needs to learn from. Take a look at what we do in our cooperatives. It's excellent. It's world class. We want to continue to replicate this. So, December 4, information will be available as much as possible at the business fellowship stand. But much more, we will be sending out a lot of information concerning this. God bless you all.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you very much, Dr. Okereme. So, there you are, just some tips on what to expect, as it were. I just want to quickly add, you saw on the news that during the week or 2 weeks ago, we were out in the schools. I will do a bit to improve the lot of the school. We motivate, as it were, the students, the teachers. Yes. Apart from giving things, you know, we built a lab there at the time, supervised by Pastor Dapo. Yes. And at the time, we supplied them with desks and tables when they had nothing and were writing their exams on the floor. And God has helped us. And we supplied books at the time. We got into the publishers of their books, and we got in maths and English books. A lot of them, most of them will be old again now. I think we should try and renew them as much as we can. And of course, we give scholarships, and then we give them this intense incentives, rather, that if you pass the school cert good enough and you gain an admission to university, this church will give you a scholarship. And we've sponsored quite a lot of them. Oh, yes, we have. We have sponsored quite a lot. During the week, we granted 15 scholarships this last week, 2 weeks ago. Hallelujah. Yes, and we've been doing it for quite a while through our ESP, and that's what you saw in the news. And apart from that, we encourage the teachers. We have a gift for the best teacher in each of the schools every year. So the teachers strive to do better. And then retiring principals, we celebrate them. Usually we don't bring them here and honor them in the church on a Sunday. That's when they are retiring to leave, just to make it a little more worthwhile for them. And God has been so good to us. And besides, amen. And besides, here in Ilupeju, just mention a few. We have been supplying water. So we came in here and we saw a lot of people were struggling. Sunday morning, you see the children that we've been carrying big basin. So we began to wonder what was happening. So we started sinking boreholes. We sank at least 10, if not more than 10. And equip them with tanks and with generators. So NEPA will not cut them off. And we are still sustaining them till today. So when we get to heaven on that day and we're standing before him and God is saying, well done, my daughter. You are saying, what did I do? He said, you are the reason that man didn't die of thirst. You say, which man? You gave 10,000 naira. And that was all you could give. You'll be surprised. And I'm glad I'm the pastor of this church. I'm the pastor of this church at this time around. So I said all this to say this quickly, that fund is opened and we would like you to please give generously towards it. And they'll be operating, or they'll be administering it through the cooperative society, so it will be well managed. we are going to see businesses revived. Even now, the businesses are dying in Jesus' name. Some few millions really will not hurt you. You know that. You know you are well endowed. Just drop it there. You may be happy about 10 or 5 of companies to come up. Help some entrepreneurs to get back on their feet. You'd be shocked what that can do. So I want to encourage you to please. You say, I don't have millions. Yeah, give thousands now. He said, I don't have thousands. Give hundreds. That's all right. You don't have hundreds. Give tens. Just make sure that you are part of it. And God will reward you heavily. In Jesus' name. I think that's it for now. Any other announcement? No, that's it. All right. Are you? All right. Hallelujah.
Father, we worship you. Just worship the Lord. Begin to bless the name of the Lord Jesus. You're too faithful to fail me. You're too faithful to disappoint me. You offer yourself in my life, and I've come to realize you're too faithful to fail me. You are who you were yesterday, today and forevermore. What you say is what you do. You never fail, you never change. You were faithful till the end. Faithful God, I worship you. I worship you. You're too faithful.
You're too faithful to fail.
To fail me,
you're too faithful.
Just said, this is a feast. That's what you said. But I would like to know you, though. Though it's not like it's very important. But as we were sitting down, you're like, wow, this is a feast. Maybe I just have a word for you, if you're the one. It's possible you're not here physically, so don't worry. But if you're here, it's good to see you. Where are you? This is a feast. Because you're about to be fed. And in that part of your life, you will never be hungry again. In the name of Jesus. What I'm saying is that you're going to find solution to questions of many years. Because he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Can somebody repeat that and thank you, Jesus? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Yes, we have a visitor, Pastor Florence Akao, ministry. We are from New Jersey. God bless you. Why didn't you stand up? Let them see you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We give God the glory. Thank you for coming. Amen. Now, if you are old or not strong, we understand. But I would rather that if you're not strong, you just stand up and receive strength in Jesus' name. Because we really want to just appreciate God with our singing and our dancing for just a few minutes before we continue. Glory be to God. Are you guys just saying, I serve the living God? Is she around? Okay, yes. Glory be to God in the highest. Hallelujah. Wait. If you are old, you can just do like this on your seat. It's understandable. No. I know you don't need to stand up. I'm just talking. But if you're not old, but somehow you are tired, I think you should just dance to the front and let the pastors lay hands on you. There's something special for you today. In Jesus' name.
Living God, oh, even the devil knows, send my true love. I serve a living God, oh, everybody knows, send I you the red nose. I serve a living God, oh, even the devil knows, send my true love.
Oh,
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. No go finish for your house. No go finish for your mouth. No go finish for your life. In the name of Jesus. Thank you very much. You may be seated. I appreciate the choir. Help me appreciate them. Come on, help me do better than you're doing. Glory be to God in the highest. I am very confident of what the Lord is about to do with somebody here. I am so, so grateful to God. You see, sometimes you're just talking, but because you have trusted God, and someone will now call in or write and say, when this happened, like, when there's a God, I give you praise. I'm confident in the name of Jesus. Today is somebody's day. In the name of Jesus. All those stubborn problems, they will melt. In the name of Jesus. I say in the name of Jesus. I'm taking my text from the book of Acts in chapter 19. It's one area that we've been looking at the showers. I pray to God for speed, and I receive speed, Lord, in the name of Jesus. I receive utterance in the name of Jesus. I receive understanding for my hearers in Jesus' name. And I receive a situation where all the glory will rise up to you in Jesus' name. Acts in chapter 19, I'll read from verse 1. And it happened while Apollos was in Corinth that Paul, having passed through the upper regions, came to Ephesus, and finding some disciples, he said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you believed?" So they said to him, "We have not so much heard whether there is a Holy Spirit." Then he said to them, "Into what then were you baptized?" So they said, "Into John's baptism." Then Paul said, "John indeed baptized with a baptism of repentance, saying to the people that they should believe in him who will come after him, that is, on Christ Jesus." When they heard these, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul had laid hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke with tongues and prophesied. Now the men were about 12 in number, or in all. And he went into the synagogue and spoke boldly for 3 months, reasoning and persuading concerning the things of the kingdom of God. But when some were hardened and did not believe, but spoke evil of the way before the multitude, he departed from them and withdrew the disciples, reasoning daily in the school of Tyrannus. And this continued for 2 years, so that all who dwelt in Asia heard the word of the Lord Jesus, both Jews and Greek. I will stop there. We'll read a little bit more than that, but for now, I will stop there. Yep. Praise the Lord. There's something good is going to happen to you. Happen to you this very day. Something good is going to happen to you. Jesus of Nazareth is passing my way. Amen. Now, it happened. Now, this was at a time when Paul, praise the Lord, when Paul was visiting Ephesus for the second and final time. He had been there before, possibly, I think, on his second missionary journey. This was his top missionary journey. And this would be the second time he would come to Ephesus. Haven't been there before and established some work. Glory be to God. You see, Paul was such a diligent person. He would carry out adequate follow-up. He never starts a thing that he will not follow up to see to conclusion. I thank God for such a spirit. So now he came back, and the Bible says that he found some disciples, glory be to God in the highest, and haven't met them, of course, glad that he met them. Can't begin to put the scripture up there for me quickly. And it's amazing that the first thing he said to them is, did you receive the Holy Spirit? When you believed? You know, I've read this thing a number of times, and I've tried to, like, why would he ask such a question? They said he met some believers. And the first question he asked the believers, did you receive the Holy Spirit when you believed? Now they answered sincerely. See what they said? We have not so much as heard whether, we don't even know that the Holy Spirit exists. Wow. So that prompted a second question. So he wasn't saying that this question and this question. If this is what we were saying, then I think I should have asked this question first. Into what then were you baptized? Because you see, your Christian life is viewed as a baptism. God given grace, we'll probably be able to touch it before we go. Somebody said, why do you always put yourself so tight and be running for time? I think it makes it good. It makes you be eager for more. And it gets you to go back to make your own research. And we thank God because we are not a church that just says that because pastor says so. You believe pastor, you trust pastor, you trust God, the pastor will communicate right. But see, that never absorbs you of going to search yourself to confirm and to dig more. So into what then were you baptized? The next verse. So they said, into John's baptism. Now a dialogue is on. Then the next thing that happened, John said, that's right. Paul said, that's right. John indeed baptized you with a baptism of repentance, saying, one of the reasons for that baptism is that, look, you are now positioned to look forward to what? Someone else is coming. Mightier than I. Okay, that's when I'm quoting him directly now. So the people that they should believe on him, who will come after him, that is on Christ Jesus. At this point, he has said enough. He baptized them in the name of Jesus. So quickly. I hope to do this quickly. God help me. Amen. Glory be to God in the highest. Why baptism? Because that, this is honest. I wrote in my margin, the purpose of baptism is to give visual testimony of our commitment to Christ, of our inward change. That's all. And besides, it is commanded. So it becomes necessary. That they were believers was not in question. That they've been baptized was not in question. If you don't understand, or if you've never heard of the Holy Ghost, then into what baptism were you baptized? They said John the Baptist. Oh yeah, okay, that's good. But that's the baptism unto repentance. That was a means to where we're going. where we're going is that now that I've baptized you, that now you are repenting, the only way you can sustain this state is to believe on him who is coming. He is not going to just get you repenting. He will remove your sin permanently. We believe him for the remission of sin, not just atonement. The baptism of John is an atonement. It's for an atonement. What's atonement? A covering. A face off. But the baptism in the name of Jesus removes it. Never to be remembered. So in other words, it gives you the ability and the power to sustain your new state. So I don't waste too much time. You say, where did Jesus command it? I'm talking baptism now. And to show you how this thing happened. First, in Mark 2, chapter 3, verse 11, if you're able to turn to it quickly. Here was John talking himself. He said, I indeed baptize you with water. Unto repentance. John said it. So Paul quoted exactly well. He said, John indeed. That was exactly what he said. And John himself said, I indeed. Matthew chapter 3, verse 11. He said, but he who is coming after me is mightier. Yeah. Than I. Go ahead, quick. Whose sandals I am not worthy to carry. He will baptize you. So my baptism will qualify you for the baptism. And that's the baptism. Wow. How? With the Holy Ghost. And he said, with fire. Glory be to God in the highest. Hear Jesus. Why am I jumping? Hey, God help me. Yeah, hear Jesus in Acts 1:5. Look at it quickly. Jesus too said the same thing. That was after resurrection. All right. Hear what he said. For John truly, John said, I indeed. Paul said, John indeed. Jesus said, John truly, yeah, baptize you with water. But you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. So you can see the setting. That baptism was a big deal. But there's something, oof, fire. There's something more interesting that we're going to be looking at. So it was important. It was like, if you've not heard of the Holy Spirit, then this must be the problem. You stopped with the baptism of John. Now, I don't want to go into that because we did that we talked about that in the Thursday showers. You turn to Acts in chapter 18, you see where they talked about the ministry of Apollos, the mighty in words. I mean, he kind of dissected the word accurately. But when Priscilla and Aquila saw him, they took him aside because they saw some lapses in what he was teaching. And they now educated him, and he became more taught in a more accurate way. But we'll get into that again as God gives us grace in the name of Jesus. And because they have been students of Apollo, so you could see that the lapses were there. And there was nothing wrong with Apollo, by the way. But Apollo just needed to take his doctrine and his teaching a notch higher, which he did through Aquila and Priscilla. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So you see that it was something, the baptism into John and baptism in the name of Jesus was something clear. And my question is this, what about you? Into what were you baptized? No, I'm asking a question. Have you been baptized at all? If so, say yes. Into what were you baptized? No, I'm not talking of Holy Ghost yet. I'm talking of regeneration. Have you been baptized? That is, have you been water baptized? Into what were you baptized? Because some don't even know what they did. By the time you read the book of Romans, you realize that when a man is baptized, like I said, is demonstrating that, look, I died with him in his death, so I'm totally buried. And when he comes out, he raises up to a newness of life. So again, and you are prophesying the coming resurrection. Because you are still going to follow. And we are demonstrating to the world that this is who we are. We are Christians. We are the redeemed of the Lord. We are the followers of Christ. Glory be to God in high. And besides, see, Jesus commanded it. We are. Book of Matthew in chapter 28. said, go into all the world and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Glory be to God in the highest. And so I'm just quickly settling that because I want to dwell more on the other side. And these were the things that Paul were doing. So let me come back quickly. And so the Bible said that because when they understood that, Paul now laid hands on them. And see what happens. Quick. Acts 19. And when Paul had laid hands on them, what happened? Eesh, let me move to one. When he lays hands on them, what happened? The Holy Spirit came upon them. And that now, as it were, explained what Paul didn't see that was beginning to happen. So the question is this. The Holy Ghost must have been the big deal here. And it really was the big deal. Because following that, the Bible says that it came upon them. And what happened? Quick. And they spoke with tongues and prophesied. Fine, maybe that's the new thing. Maybe now they are speaking in tongues and now they are prophesying. But what if they didn't speak in tongues? What if they didn't prophesy? Would it mean that they didn't get it? No, they still got it. But we are told that they had the privilege of speaking in tongues and they were prophesying. So that means that something has happened. And that thing now will require some manifestation, as it were. Because see, every gift of God comes with its responsibility. Every blessing comes with its responsibility. Glory be to God in the highest. I say glory be to God in the highest. And they prophesied. The next verse, quickly. Now the men were about 12. Now, next verse. And he now went into the synagogue and spoke boldly for 3 months. Reasoning and persuading concerning the things of the kingdom of God. Again, I want to pause here quickly. If you observe in Acts chapter 1, that is post-resurrection, the Bible says for 40 days and 40 nights, Jesus was with them and he was teaching concerning things concerning the kingdom. Glory be to God in the highest. And a lot of times when I read that, I'm like, I wish I can be part of that or get some script of this teaching. But then the Bible just dropped hints. What were the hints? They said that this time, they said, with this kind of teaching, are you now going to restore the kingdom to Israel? You see how men think. We are so materialistic. We make material, as it were, our number one priority. We should never be. The spirit should be our number one priority. If the spirit be your number one priority, then the others will follow automatically. But Jesus answered them. He said, look, it's not given to you to know the times that is hidden in the heart of the Father. But you will receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. And then you'll be my witnesses. And that gave me a clue. So the things about the kingdom was about the Holy Ghost. Was about human beings being filled or being regenerated by the Holy Spirit and being filled with the Holy Spirit and then carrying out exploits. Amen. Kingdom exploits, even here on earth. That's it. So the crux of the matter was the Holy Ghost. Being filled with the Holy Ghost. Let's continue quickly. But when some were hardened and did not believe, but spoke evil before the multitude, he departed from them and withdrew the disciples, reasoning daily in the school of Tyrannus. Again, I don't want to belabor that. But if indeed you have the Holy Ghost, you will know when to step out. You know when to withdraw. But we've not discussed that. I'll bring more scriptures to buttress that. You say, where are you coming from? Honestly, I've not thought of it, but it's hitting me right now. He said, do not be deceived. A bad company will corrupt good morals. If I cannot influence them for the kingdom, come on, get out. Otherwise, they will influence you for their own kingdom. So again, it boils down to your motive. So why are you keeping their company? Is it such that they should see your light and glorify your Father? Is it just that you prefer their company because of the pleasure? And the fake accolade? Put it back there. He departed and went to school of Tyrannus and continued. And this he continued to do for 2 years. Now look at the result. So that all who dwelt in Asia had the word of the Lord Jesus. Now that every time I read that, I get excited. So you mean with a conviction of the Holy Ghost that this is where God has called me, I can stay here doing the work and the whole world will be affected. There will be some whose ministries must take them around the world, but there will be some that they will just be there doing their work, and the ministry spreading will be the reason why they have to start moving. And I'm like, Paul was in Ephesus for 2 years, whether it was 2 years and 3 months or the 3 months were embedded in 2 years, I don't know. But he was preaching. See. Put it back again. And this he continued for 2 years. And yeah. Can you back off to 9 again? Let me see. 9, please. Okay. But where some years? Okay, right, 10. And this continued, and yes, and then 11. Now, good, now I stop. But where I was looking for is this. That the message he preached was the message of the kingdom. And of course, the conclusion again is this, just like I saw in the case of Jesus Christ in the book of Acts chapter 1. And what particular can I hold on to if I'm looking for the script of his message? Have you received the Holy Spirit? That's it. Now that you're a believer, have you received the Holy Spirit? That is it. And he now discovered that they never even have heard of the Holy Ghost at all. He now said to sit down and teach them. And what was the result? The whole of Asia were affected in just 2 years. Ladies and gentlemen, for someone under the sound of my voice, it's not going to be life as normal anymore. In the name of Jesus. It looks simple, but this is what's going to cause the total turnaround. The answer to the question you have been waiting for. And the thing that beats me is that how can I be this equipped and yet be suffering? No, that's the truth. Pastor, are you assuring me that this stubborn situation will bow to this Holy Ghost ministry? Yes! What if it doesn't? That's not for me to think or reason. I was sharing with the pastors only some few days back. I was confronted with a situation that I was like, from where? Where is this coming from? Oh, glory be to God in the highest. It was a reminder of these things I'm saying to you, and I saw myself yelling. I come against you. Why? Because I have authority. Because he says, look, thanks be to God, who always causes Tyro to triumph the word. And I began to realize my arsenal in Christ Jesus. And I will yell in the name of Jesus. I will say, back to God. And the situation will change, physically speaking. And within 5 minutes, everything calmed down. And wow, I feel the fire now. And I began to ask myself the questions. What's this? It's not like I've not heard these things before. It's not like I've never read these things before. within 2 years. Verse 11, unusual miracles. Verse 11 again, let's see. Unusual miracles by the hand of Paul. If the Bible does not put unusual, it will still be understood. Miracles! Miracles are things that are not normal. Help me tell that brother, I think he's tired. But when miracles are unusual, I just say to somebody here, under the sound of my voice, in the name of Jesus, it won't take somebody else. I'm talking about you. You open your mouth, unusual will begin to happen to you. No, but it's true. But it's true. You will pinch yourself to say, is this real? In the name of Jesus. He met some disciples. There were 12 in numbers. And by the time he asked one or two questions, he had to educate them. And the moment they had a bit of understanding, they yielded. And that changed their lives forever and changed a lot of things in Ephesus forever. He remained there for 2 years and affected the whole of Asia. And people from far distances that could not bring the sick would come and throw their handkerchiefs on his body and pick it back and go back. Hallelujah. He wasn't even doing anything extra. He was just preaching. The Bible said he was disputing and persuading them concerning. He was speaking the word of God. I said within 2 years, the whole of Asia heard the word of the Lord Jesus Christ. It was the word that made a difference. I see. Let me just get into a step before I. Please, excuse me. Struggle for. Can I please beg for. Why are you laughing? Can I take extra few minutes? Yeah. And see, it's because of you. Believe me, because you're going to start commanding things. In the name of Jesus. Somebody thought you are the one directly I'm pointing to. Who are you? I pointed this way, and you thought you are the very one. Okay, see, the person is never here. So you are the only one. Come. You. Yes, you. You could have been anybody. Quick. My time now. They won't give me extra time. Give me your hand. I don't know you. Father, in the name of Jesus, surprise her. By the help of your spirit, do the unusual. Father, quicken her faith in the name of Jesus. You will return with a testimony. Usually when it happens that way, I don't even know anything's happening. When she comes to give her testimony, you'll be surprised what she carried here. You'll be surprised. Remember the leader sat there on a Thursday, I didn't know. Holy Ghost told somebody that they come. She said, I agree with somebody here, the pastor should call me. I said, ah. Because today is my birthday. I said, ah. I didn't know. What a testimony yesterday from the... And the person said, if it's not Thursday showers, I think I'll prefer 31st September. When I read it, I'm like, oh my goodness, this is interesting. There's somebody today. Something unusual. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Where did I stop? Quickly, help me. Okay, fine. So what did Paul teach them? Let me just jump. What did he teach them? At least I have a... We have a privilege. Privilege of what? Of the letters of Paul. He wrote quite some letters, particularly when he was in the prisons, about to be killed. Killed? Yes. Paul? Yes. He was killed. And yet. Chapter 5, quickly. Go to verse 15. Quick for me. 15. Chapter 5. Quick. At least that gives a clue into some things that he's teaching. But before then, remember in the house of Cornelius, to show you things about this Holy Ghost, when Peter got there, guess what happened? The Bible said he was still speaking when what? The Holy Spirit did what? Fell upon them. He was still speaking to get them to a place where he would baptize them. Pow! And then when the protocols have been broken, he said, can anybody now stop them from being water baptized? So the two will still be, will still happen. And so he baptized them. But while he was still speaking, so, but what did Peter teach there? This one I'm saying now is 40-something, verse 38. That how God anointed Jesus Christ of Christ with the Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, and power. He was still teaching them. Bam! The Holy Ghost came. The minute he anointed him, bam! I'm anointed you. I'm anointing you too. That's all. So the big deal is that you must be anointed with the Holy Ghost if you're a believer. And you must value what you have, period. So look at verse 15. Quick. Ephesians 5. So then, can somebody help me start interceding for this guy? Ephesians 5, 15. Taking 2 minutes out of my time. My boy. See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise. Now look at that. See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise. I mean, this is giving me a clue into the kind of thing that Paul was teaching in Ephesus. Because now this was a follow-up letter to what he was teaching. Glory be to God in the highest. It says, walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise. You'd be foolish to walk carelessly. And see what he was saying. Why? So that you can redeem the time. You know, simply put, so you can seize every opportunity. Hear me clearly. No matter how horrible it looks, every day comes with plenty of opportunities. Every day! If you keep on singing the song of the world, of the season, of what is happening, you will see. But if you let the whole world work richly, you will see. Every day, new mercies. Every day, opportunities. You want to seize the opportunities? Walk with wisdom. Simple. Why? The days are evil. I didn't tell them in the first service. I was rushing for time, like, now again, see, I have to go. If you see this in the, if you see it in the Amplified Classic, or you see it in the Message, can somebody quickly read Message for me? Let them hear. When the word is shouting, nay, 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 that's your best time. They didn't respond here. Let me go away from it. Because you refuse to respond. I'm telling you, when there's sin, there's a casting, and that's when you'll be shouting, there's a lifting up. Yeah, this guy, give me that same verse in Message now. Yeah. No, a message will be good. Okay. So that I won't refer, I won't ask him to do anything after this. I will read it myself. Okay, look at, shall we read together the same scripture? Don't waste your time. Don't waste your life on useless work. Mere busy work. It's giving from 11. I know, but I want 15 straight away. I can. If you read this one, you will not know. Give me 15 straight away. Is it? 15 is embedded there. So watch your steps. You just got it for me now. So watch your steps. Use your head. Make them. Come on, talk to me now. Make the most of what? Every chance you get. Why? These are. Go back to our King James. In Ephesians. Oh boy. Please bear with me. It might be no. Beko. Mbog. Yeah. Okay, thank you. See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise. redeeming the times. You know what it means? That is that please seize every available opportunity. Redeem the time because the days are evil. Next verse. Therefore, do not be unwise. You see the way Bible talks. If you don't really grab this thing about the Holy Ghost, it makes you unwise. A believer that does not know this is unwise. God have mercy on us. Therefore, do not be unwise, but understand what the will of the Lord is. Quick. And do not be drunken with wine in which is dissipation. Remember, he said, understand the will of the law of the Lord is what will deliver you. But he said, do not be drunken with wine in which is dissipation, but be filled with the Spirit. Hallelujah. Many versions say, but be constantly filled with the Spirit. Glory be to God in the highest. Speaking to one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, and I feel the fire now. And making melody in your heart to the Lord. Giving thanks always to the Lord in all things to God, the Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I stopped there quickly. Now, the question is, do you see where the Holy Ghost came there again? He says, if you really want to seize the opportunity, if you don't want to waste your life, you don't want to waste your time, he said, please, don't be drunken with wine when it's excess. The issue is not so much wine. He's using it to compare. He's just using comparative to explain what he's saying to you. The issue where he's going is that be filled with the Spirit. That's what he's saying. He says, do not, but be filled with the Spirit. And why wine? Can I quickly remind you, on the day of Pentecost, when they came and they had them shout, blah, 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 and they saw fire on their head, they said, this was a drunken how? With wine. Here you see. Peter said, how can I be drunken this early? Are you okay? Uh-huh. So when you see wine being used to compare, this man, Paul, knew the Bible. But see what somebody said to me. I told you that wine will get you intoxicated and you will lose your head. In the same way, the Holy Ghost will get you, yay, but you will lose your head. You will not lose your head. Ha! He says, you know why he compares the two? See, have you ever seen a man, a drunken person that remains drunk the whole day or the whole week? For him to remain drunk the whole week, that must be top up. Regular top up. The same way for you to be filled with the Spirit and be used in this manner, that must be top up. So the issue of being filled with the Holy Ghost is a big deal in the kingdom. I am sure the change you are looking for has started. In the name of Jesus. It does not matter what is prevailing or what is not prevailing. It does not matter where everybody decided to sleep and face. You face the Bible. Be filled constantly with the Holy Ghost. That's it. I know what somebody said. He said, when you don't understand what it means, when he said, for you to be wise, be filled with the Spirit. And he said, look at parallels. Look at Galatians and look at Ephesians. The same thing. What you see in Ephesians 5, you find in Galatians chapter 3. He said, then what? Come on, give me again quickly. I'll close it. And be not be drunken with wine in which is excess, but filled with the Spirit. Next line. Speaking. See the effect. Every word you say will change. Hey, we won't be forcing that. Stop speaking negative. You will not be negative. Oh, dear, you're not in it. You'll be so filled that when you are speaking, you'll be speaking. Your interpersonal communication will be such that it lifts up people. Amen. You are overflowing. You know what the person said? He said the first three effects got to do with music. Music of the heart. Music of the heart. You talk of joy. You talk of love. You feel constantly. Now you can now see why the work of the fruit of the Spirit will keep on flowing. If you read this chapter, you see from chapter 4, chapter 3, walk in unity, walk in love. Leave walking out the Spirit's gifts, then walk in wisdom. So in Colossians chapter 3, guess what? It said, let the word of God dwell richly in you. Then the same thing will happen. But pastor, so what does it mean to be filled constantly with the Holy Spirit? He says the word I speak to you, their spirit and their life. You think you can dwell in the word and you'll be free. But there's a place where it will fall on you, but you want to sustain it. Get into the word. He was disputing with them. After he listens, he was bold. He was speaking the word, and boom, the whole place changed. Kings were dropping charms. People were dropping charms. Life were being changed. People were coming from distance, and miracles everywhere. And now he says, for you to really manifest the fruits of the Spirit, the same thing shall rise. Welcome, Holy Spirit. That's what he said. He's saying, feel me again. That's what he's saying. We are in your presence. Feel us. Again and again and again and again and again and again. Oh, yes, live big inside of me. Welcome, Holy Spirit. We are in your presence. Fill us with your power. Live
inside of us.
Anytime they were in trouble and they lift their heads to heaven, quoting the Bible in intercession, fire will fall. They'll be filled again. From today, in the name of Jesus. Where you have wept, God will not only hear, you will be a source of inspiration to many. God will use you to deliver many out of the shackles and lies of the devil. In the name of Jesus! And every lie of the devil to stop you becomes futile. In the name of Jesus! Because it's getting clearer that it's not by power. It's not by might. It's only by the Spirit of God. Is Holy Ghost infilling a big deal? One of the biggest deals in your Christian living. Want to make a success of your life? Please grab him. I feel the fire. Father, I share with this man that is really craving like no man's business. This man that is crying for more, Father, fill him in the name of Jesus. Yes. 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 Hallelujah. The Bible says, in Samaria, they send the apostles there. After the whole of them have been given their lives, they said, because at that time, the Holy Ghost was yet to fall on them. They pray for them, the whole country, the whole city changed. I pray same over your home. I pray it over Nigeria. I pray it over Fountain. In the name of Jesus. And I pray that the spirit of forgetfulness will never trouble you again in Jesus' name. As far as it concerns the word of God, it will never trouble you again in the name of Jesus. The Holy Ghost himself will remind you. I'm waiting for your testimony. In the name of Jesus. If you have been part of this service since we started, I now know that yes, you need the Holy Ghost. First, you need to be born again. That's the truth. And you are making a decision to do that, why don't we pray together? Church, join them. Say, Lord Jesus, thank you for your love. You are the Savior of mankind. Cleanse me from my sins. Fill me with your Spirit. Henceforth, use me for your glory. In your most precious name, I pray. Amen. Father, I commit all these ones to you who really have this conviction, and I pray in this prayer that you will fill them anew with your Spirit, and then you will mature them even by your Spirit and through your word, and use them for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. If you are in this category, please write us, Fountain at TFOLC, the Fountain of Life Church.org, or Pastor Taiwo at TFOLC. We will respond to you. We will help you grow quickly in Jesus' name. It's offering time. Father, thank you for the grace to give. It's out of the much you've given us. We can never sponsor you on anything, not financially at least. You are the creator of all things. So today, accept our thanks in Jesus' name. accept our offering in Jesus' name. Take all the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Yep. Somebody shout hallelujah. Let's do it like they used to do it. Somebody scream. Yes, I could hear the voices of the youth. Shall we rise up? Hallelujah. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely. Goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we will dwell in the presence of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set us free from the law of sin and death. And so sin shall not have dominion over us, because the same Spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells inside of us, and he quickens our mortal bodies for the glory of his holy name. Amen. Have a glorious week in Jesus' name. Yes, sir.
Thank you.